introduce yourself before you leave today. We also have a school counsellor who helps and supports us as a team as well, and families and children who perhaps need a little bit of extra time to settle. So that is the team. But here I've also got Mrs. Debbie, who's our whole school head of learning technology, who's here today to help us all get through and understand a little bit about the systems. Once you've been here a little while, it is very clear, but just in the beginning, I think like any school, things are new. There's a little bit of getting used to. I just had that up earlier, that's our school Wi-Fi. You've got your own devices, that's what you will use to log on. I think I might be logged on once, it will automatically log on again.
Forget it the next time you come in the following day, so
I'll forget it. I do apologise, yesterday we had a different, that is the one we used, we had a different login. We came back on the holidays to discover that the secondary school had decided to change their logins, and what we didn't know is it automatically changed ours too, but it has been reversed back. So we're trying to remember that one, but the office staff are able to help you with that. I wanted to focus out to introduce you to some of our key members of the office, just so that you know who they are, a font of all knowledge and really extremely helpful. We have Fatima, who's our head of our office at JB. She sits in the office and looks after and coordinates everything that happens in the school. So you will often see her in and around in the office. Unfortunately, we'd like to introduce you to Annie. Annie looks after many things at school, but particularly our school meals and monitors that and enters everything into our system. So she's the person to talk to in the office if you needed any more information about our school meals or if you've got any issues with it, whether that's logging on, we're going to show you in a moment, or you just want to talk a little bit more about it. So Annie's there, she's there every day with the children. Right at the front desk, we have Miss Nessa, who I understand nearly knows everything. I've been here a long time at school, but I think Nessa knows perhaps a little bit more than me. She's supported by Ayu, who's manning the front desk at the moment. And the children are told in school that if you ever get lost or you're not sure about anything during the day, go and see Miss Nessa. You'll see a long line of parents in the morning as well. But if you phone the school, it's most likely to be Nessa that you will get on the phone. She'll be able to direct you to the right person. But if she can't answer your question, we'll get back with somebody to be able to do it. So it's a really important member. So you can see their faces, and it's a welcome face when you go into the office. I know that Annie and Nessa are going to go back and check what's happening. Thank you. Just going to talk a little bit about the different ways we communicate in school. We're going to introduce you to the Class Gateway, which is our online portal secure system with lots of information, and it also has our online systems. We do have members of our PTA here today. Just a quick word about the PTA and our role in class reps, and then obviously as we go on throughout, any opportunities for you to ask questions. So communicate, we do a lot of communicating in school. I think most of it will be done through email. If you find that you're not getting any emails or information from the school, do please come into the school office so that we can check we've got your details. You should have had a welcome email yesterday from our head of school, Mr. Roger Schultz. So if you didn't or aren't sure, please just talk to us at the end. So all letters that are sent home with the children or from the leadership teams on the campuses are sent home in an email form. That will also include if children are going on trips and things are happening in school, it will come as a letter on an email and you'll be able to click on it to go to some admission slip, or if you need to pay something bus trip or the trip, you'll be able to click again on that email, on that letter, and it will direct you to the payment system. So very occasionally we will send out a paper letter and it will be there put in the children's diaries, but the vast majority will go out through email. So it is important that we have your correct email and keep us updated. Also with phone numbers, we use SMS system for really short messages. hopefully yesterday, you may have had on your phone a message, SMS to say what today's workshop was about. So just important short things sometimes, reminders will go out through SMS, so something just important and quick will go out. And certainly every week before up here at workshops, we will send that out. If you didn't think you got that, please check and make sure you've registered the right numbers. We usually do it priority one and priority two. It's important as well when we go on children on school trips, if they're in a residential or they're away, we will use those numbers to send good information to say that they've arrived safely, they're having a good time. And also any updates on buses, if there's been any delays, we would send it out through SMS. The children hopefully may have come home yesterday with one of our link books or diaries. There's some different ones depending on the age and stage of the children in there. The teacher has got some information about the school, it's got the school rules, the school song, lots of facts about the school. It's also, a teacher will have put in when the children have PE or maybe when they need their library books as well. The children at the school will use it to write notes in it, which indicate when they've got to bring things into school. And there is a space if you need to write a quick message, which is a non-confidential message, a quick message to the teacher. This works particularly well for the younger children. The teachers are looking at it every day. Obviously, for our older students, we'd expect them to show a message or if they've got something in their diary. But you may also email the teachers as well. They will often use that as a form of contact. But obviously, if it's something important or something a special message that you need to pass on, then that needs to come through the office. Because the teachers are obviously are teaching, will not be sitting looking at their emails just once or twice during the day. So any urgent messages go to the office, and somebody will phone you back. We do have parent-teacher and specialist conferences, another way we communicate how the children are doing at the school throughout the year. We have a letter going out today, in fact, about our specialist conferences. So it's opportunities for parents to meet our specialist staff, for example, PE, modern foreign languages, our teacher, music teachers. And later on this term, there's also an opportunity to come in and meet your child's class teacher. Our existing parents have had that opportunity in term one, and we have it again in term two. But I will be talking to the teachers, hopefully they will get in contact with you before then anyway, just to let you know how your child has set. Class times, we have a class times, which is a newsletter which goes out every Friday. That again is emailed out, it's emailed out to you with a link on it, and you can click and it's got information on what's happening that week in school, both campuses, the primary campus and secondary campus. It's key dates, articles about our principals, and there's lots, as you'd expect, the school newsletter. You can also access all that through our gateway that we'll be coming to in a moment. We're also live on Twitter and Facebook, and often some of the messages that come out of school will have a link again to our Twitter feed and to our Facebook. So the Facebook, there's the official school Facebook page, which is information about things that are happening in school. That's more for the general public. Anything which is kind of secure, specific to us, will be on our gateway. But the PTA, at this point, I'll mention that they also have their own Facebook page, and you need to ask to join. And Alex is here from our head of PTA. Explain a bit.
Yeah, we have a Facebook group called KLASS PTA, which is a skill group. So if you want to join that, you need to search for KLASS PTA and then request to join the group. So not the Facebook page, but the actual specific group. And then we check with the school that you are a parent of the school before we accept you into the group. It's a huge Facebook, it's a really great resource because we've got all the information about school events, what's going on, but also you can use it as an opportunity to ask questions. So if you want to check something or ask advice from another parent about something outside of school, you can use it to do that as well.
Thank you. Importantly today, we're going to introduce you to our class gateway, which is kind of a portal for all the different systems that we have in the school. Particularly today, we're going to show you where to find information, a little bit about KLASS Ops, which you can see is our online payment system for paying for things, and the CHQ, which is the system for signing up for clubs and clubs and activities, which you won't need to do now, but you will need to do for term three. So I'm going to hand over to
Okay, so my name's David Debbie, I'm the head of learning technology. If you get any problems with any of this sort of stuff, you can email the office managers, you can email me direct, it doesn't really matter, it will more or less sort of find its way to me eventually anyway. So what I'm going to do today is just talk you through a couple of the systems that we use, and then if you've got a device on you, then you can try and follow along and have a look at this as well. If you haven't got your usernames and passwords yet, I do apologise for that, we'll make sure you get them, we'll get them to you very shortly. If you're not sure what they are, we can give them to you now as well. So, what we've tried to do is sort of align all of our systems to work through a single username and password. Now, you might have been given some details already for something called Parent Portal. Has anybody got that? It's got a generic email, which is parents@alice-smith. If you have been given that, you can basically forget that. You've sort of arrived during the transition time at this point where we're moving from one system to another. The only one that you will need is that email address that's specific to you. Now the easiest way to remember it is on your cards, which you've all got around your neck, you should have a membership number. And a membership number, it's basically your membership number, the first letter of your surname or the name you use to register your children with at the school, alice-smith.edu.my. That's your username, that's your email address, and then your password is unique to you. So that's basically what it looks like, or what it should look like. And we are a Google school, we use a lot of Google services, our students use Google services, we will share a lot of letters and stuff with you through Google services. And this, that's basically a Google email address, okay? So I'll talk to you a bit more about that. Basically, anywhere you see that, signing with Google, it's this here. Now, if one of our systems doesn't use Google, doesn't talk to Google, and CHQ is an example of that, I'll show you that in a minute, then it's exactly the same, but you just drop the @alicesmith.edu.my, and it's the same password. So, as Alison said, Class Ops is our payment system. CHQ is where our children or you choose your activities. Anyone got any children at the secondary campus as well as the primary campus? Yeah? Okay. Children at the secondary campus choose their own activities. Children at the primary campus, you choose them. So if you can't choose an activity for a secondary child, that's because the privilege is given to them. And the other one, obviously, is the class gateway, which we'll have a quick look at in a sec. Now, has anybody got any children in reception year one? Okay, now you will find that you'll be using this in reception, and then this one here, it's called the Teach Cloud in year one and two. And basically, these are not yet aligned to the same username and password. So the teacher of your child's class will issue you with a username and password to be able to access those systems. The only other one we use is this one, which is the bus tracking system. And that's an app you can get for your phone, and it will basically show you where the buses are on a map. And I think you look at
You can't that, but you can track where the school bus is. So if you've signed up for the school bus, you should this week get an email from the school or the bus company giving you more information about how to download the tracking app, and with a special password you need to the school, so that you can track the buses that your child is on. Just the other ones that David mentioned, the tapestry and the teacher file, are kind of reporting systems where you can see what your child is doing at the school, and it kind of builds a bank of the different skills and activities that your child is doing. So these ones are other ones that we use, but they do need separate passwords. They can't be accessed at the moment through our class task gateway.
One of our objectives this year is to try and get a lot of these systems aligned to the same username and password that you've been given, so you'll be updated as we move through that. So if we just have a quick look at this, easiest way to get onto the school systems is to remember this address here, classgateway.edu.my. If you Google Class Gateway, it's the first result that comes up. You can also access it through the school website, but I would wholly recommend just adding that address into your browser. From there, you can get to everything else. So that is the reason why we need to remember that. So, Mr. Kim, if I could ask you just to go to Class Gateway. So if you want to try this on your devices now, you can. When you go to Class Gateway, this is the page. You've got a little video at the bottom here which can will talk you through the login process, but if you've ever logged into Gmail before, it should be fairly obvious. You'll see links to all of our social media stuff down here. You don't need to log into any of that because it's public information. But if you do want to get into the Class Gateway, then we're going to click this one, to sign in with Google, and then you'll need to use your Alice Smith email address and password to get into that.
Just stick your hand up if you get stuck.
I'll just have Mr. Kit and put his password in and I'll show you. Quite a lot of parents, including ourselves included, have already got Google accounts, okay? Now, just walk back up to the top, sorry. Thank you. Now, if you are already logged in to your browser using an existing Google account, a personal one, when you go to the Class Gateway, it'll tell you you don't have access, and then you'll see your email address up there. Now, Mr. Kit is logged in using his school one, so that's fine, but you will see a personal one in there. So you've got two choices here. You can click on the arrow next to it, and you can click sign out, and then you can log in using your school one. Or, if you don't want to do that, because you want to be able to run two simultaneously, you can use what's called a private or incognito window. Now, it doesn't matter whether you're on a tablet, Android device, a PC, a Mac, every browser these days has the facility to do this. And what you do is you click on the dots. Now this is Chrome, it might vary from browser to browser. If you click on it, you'll see new incognito window there. It might say private window, it might say in private. There's various different names for it, but it all does the same thing. If you click on that, it will open up a window that won't have your old credentials in it. So then when you go to Class Gateway, it will provide you with that login window. Now we've already got an incognito window open, so if I can get to close that, we'll go back to, we've lost it again, haven't we? That's great. So, when you've logged into the Class Gateway, this is what you will be presented with. Now, this really is just about the parents. This is all information for you. If you go to the news one, that'll take you to our news page. Okay. All right. I won't go through all of these. It's more a case of just having a look around and seeing what you can find. If you go back to the Class Gateway, school calendar has got a lot of, obviously is the school calendar. There's lots of sporting events and parent workshops and things like that will show on there. If you're a new family, this one will probably be quite useful to you. It's got a lot of information on living in KL, the new processes for starting school. Bus information is here. I'll come back to CHQ. Any letters or presentations, if you come to a parent workshop, all the presentations will go into this one here. Any letters home, and bearing in mind these are sort of whole school or U group specific letters. If it's a letter that's just addressed to you, it won't show up in that one there, okay? But any sort of whole school letters that are sent out will go through there. The school menus can be found here. There's a lot of useful medical information in here. Class Ops I'll come back to. There's a Class PTA site here, and I believe Alex is working on that this year. So you should start to see more information appearing on there. Class 1-to-1, has anybody got any students in children in year 5 and 6? 7, 8, 9? Okay. Any information relating to iPads? will be found in this site here, and then there's a bit more information there. I'd strongly suggest getting onto this, having a look around. It's got loads of really useful information. The only other thing that's relevant really at the moment, can you scroll down a bit please, are these here, okay? So this will give, this is student access. If you've got any students in EP, all the subjects departments have pages where resources and things like that are posted. JB, we've got class pages, so your child will have a class page. And also, if the school's ever closed for haze for any reason, which happened a bit last year, you'll find homework in there. And then you can access the library system there as well. So you don't need to worry too much about this. The only really two areas of this site that you're going to need to look at are CHQ, which as I've said before, is our activity system, and Class Ops. Now we'll start with Class Ops because that's our payment system and that's how you order lunches. Now if you click on the Class Ops link, it will sign in with Google, and because you're signed into the Class Gateway, you're automatically signed into Class Ops as well. So if you click on that, click on the Allow button, okay, you're into the payment system. Should be into the payment system. Can I suggest we go back to that incognito window? Do it again. Hasn't remembered Class Gateway got into you guys. I'm a bit disappointed about that. There you go, you are already signed in. So, that's it. I did test with your account, so it should work. Yes, okay. Okay. So, once you're in the payment system, would you like to talk about this?
Yeah, once you're. Once we're in there, you can see that's actually as Mr. Pietnam's children. It's got your his wife's name there and some of your different accounts. Up at the top, you can see that in order to be able to pay for things, you have to be able to put money. You have to be able to put money in, and you can do that through two ways. You can pay through your credit, put in money through your credit card, or you can go into the accounts office and pay with cash, and they will top up your amount. Is that right, Phil? Yeah.
Yeah, it's all so, as you would do for any online payment, whether you've got the verified by Visa or the MasterCard secure code, and they send you the SMS with the code on. So it's all registered and secured in that way. So it's just like making any other payment online. I go into the Alice Smith reload, and then I can simply charge up with any amount I want and go straight to my credit card and send them the PIN number.
So you've got 97 rupees there. You can.
I'm hoping Mr. Debbie's going to charge some more.
Yeah, he's going to charge up some more.
Here we go. I'm all right, Steve.
Yeah, go on. I'll get the message.
Right. So this is it. It will only come to my phone. So when you confirm, you have to confirm, and then
do
I
actually want me to.
Yeah, go on. You can. I'll need to pay for kids' lunch next week.
Hurry up, because it'll...
No,
maybe
I'm okay
for
that. Right.
Oh, it's all live, isn't it?
Yes, you just topped up with 100.
I'm assuming then, therefore, you're going to use your card.
Yes.
You've already put your card in.
Yeah.
If you have any trouble with the accounts office or a Pratima at the front office, and Annie will help you top up. But not only will Phil, you'll use that for the paying for school meals, but also if you're going on a school trip, you will be directed back in to buy things. So ordering for school school meals, we have a school meal program. Orders need to be in online by Thursday midnight for the following week. After that, it cuts off, and you have to come in and smile nicely in the office, and they will see what they can
see.
Yeah, they can see what they will do for you. But in order, obviously, to give some advance notice for the catering, our caterers, and chefs, we try and get as much information as possible beforehand. So Thursday, 12 o'clock is a cutoff. Week. But you can do several weeks at a time, and we're expanding that. So what's on offer? at a cost of 16 ringgit, it gives a break time snack, which is a buffet breakfast with toast and cereal. There's yogurt and fruit, and there's even one special item every day as well, so children have got a choice for that. And a hot lunch, and that's where you'll need to make the choice. The breakfast comes automatically, you don't get a choice for that, but the lunch will be a Western, a vegetarian, or an Asian option, and it will tell you what it is, and you just need to make that that choice to buy. You can see that's what it looks like. Later on in a couple of weeks, we're actually also going to hopefully add in an afternoon snack, and that's the children stay for late, the older children, and they stay for late clubs. We run quite a lot of late selected clubs, and we have many children here till about 5 o'clock. So there's going to be another additional option you'll see later on for them to sign in for that. But if you want a school meal, it would be 16 ringgit, and the only choice you have to make is what day you want, whether you want all the days, and you just choose one day a week, whether it's just an Asian or Western or vegetarian. What happens back in classes in the morning, every morning the teachers can then log on when they're doing their register, and it will give a list of the children in their class for that day who are having school meals, and it will say which option they're having, and the children are issued with a band, a different coloured band, depending on whether they're having a Western or Asian or vegetarian. And that allows when they go down to the dining hall, they know which queue to be in, and they're given the set meal, which comes with the fruit and bread. So that's what it looks like. You can have a go at trying to sign up again. Come and see Fatima or Annie in the office if you're unsure. Anything else you want to say about
It's not just for paying for meals either, it can be for any other transactions that are available for your child. Depending on the year group they're in, for example, year one might be going on a trip to the theatre and there's a donation, a payment to be made. Well, that can be also made through
Class
Ops.
Can you show us
sure. And even for other trips as well, some of those extracurricular activities, the for this year events, the overseas trips and such like, they can all be paid for. I'll shout from all this side.
So unless there is an activity for your child, I think you won't see. So you go to events and trips, you're able to select your child. There's a drop down that's got 3 children. At the moment there's no trips and events available, but each time a letter goes out, say one year group is going to the student, it will come up there and you'll be able to see it. At the moment there's no trips available for him, but that is where they will be.
Previously paid for, so I can see what meals my children have had, or what trips they've been on, what money I paid in, and have an account statement for that as well.
They've also introduced a cancel button. Have you ordered any meals?
Not this term.
So if you when you've ordered it, you could go in and see what you've ordered, and it does allow you to cancel it if you would like up to 24 hours beforehand.
So this is the statement for last term and the transactions that were made, whether it was for the Christmas party, you can see a meal order, a trip that my daughter's going on, all sorts of different things, and you can see what's being paid. And of course, I've just topped up on my credit card and then simply paid this off. As you can see, there's not much balance on it now. Beginning of the term, I need to top up and get ready to chip away at it throughout the term.
Basically, you need to put money on it in order to be able to pay. It is secure. The only thing you can do is pay for your own children on class ops. The best thing is just to go in and try, and then come and see us if you can't find your way around.
Alright, so that's the payment system. The only other one we need to really worry about is the beginning of each term, and that's CHQ. Now CHQ is one of those things which doesn't sync with Google, unfortunately, so we would need to revert to the first portion of the username that we've given you, and you would log in here. So it's the membership number, first letter of the surname, and then the same password. Okay. And And this is where you can now select your child and choose activities for them. Now, there is a window for this at JB, and you'll be informed when that is.
So for signing up for this term, the window was at the end of last term, so they had about 45 days where parents could go online, just like Phil's gone, you can select which child you want to do, and it will show you what activities are available. The sign up is now closed. You can still go on, I think, Phil, and see what has been chosen, but the sign up, we can't sign up anymore. At the end of this term, information will come up about signing up for term three, and this is where you will go to see it. At the moment, if you're new and you arrived this term, we will have had to do that manually for you. But now that you're here, you will be able to sign up for the next sign up.
And year one will get.
Yes, so the sign up for clubs and activities is from year two onwards, all the way up through the school. But in year one, we do it in the third term, so next term for year one. But at the moment, it's year two and above. As Mr. Denny said, at the secondary school, the children use their own Google School login to be able to do it.
Yeah, you can view the activities that they've chosen, but you can't change them. So if you've got children at JB, obviously then you do need to choose an activity. Now, because the window's now closed, this looks a little bit different to what it would look like when it's open. But when it's open, if I remember rightly, you've basically got a list of drop-down boxes, and you would choose the activities depending on the day and the term, based on what appears in those boxes.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
There we go. Alright, and then you go back, as Mr. Kitten just did then, I think you click on the home button if you want to. If you've got more than one child, you can go up to where it says select profile here, okay, and that will take you back to your student list, your child list, and then you can assign an activity for a different child as well. Okay. Again, if you do get any problems with this, it's best to just pop into the office. All the office managers and support staff know how to use the system, and they can work through it with you if you do need to. Okay, so we've talked about a lot of this. One of the other things that it is worth remembering is that if you've got children in year 5 and 6, they use Google Classroom. Don't know if you've ever come across Google Classroom, but any homework and things like that will go onto Google Classroom, and you just need to basically grab your child's iPad and have a look to find out what it is that they've been set for that one. Sports fixtures and things like that, obviously. If it's information relevant to parents, it will be in the parent letters. However, if it's information that your children might need, for example, what kit to bring, a lot of the information and links to the letters can be found on the student area of the class gateway. Mr. Morgan is very good at sort of maintaining that sort of information, so it's worth having a look at that. And then also there are quite a lot of resources on the class pages for your children to use at home throughout the year. Okay, I'm not worrying about that one too much. So,
yeah,
that's more or less it. As I say, if you do get any problems, do let us know. Yeah, the app will actually be removed from the App Store on the 14th of January anyway.
Okay, so
just ignore it, yeah.
So that's for your existing, existing parent
and
app.
And will we get another
award? That's a secret, I can't.
Does anyone have any questions on the gateway or any of the systems?
School fees,
I don't think you can pay those through.
No, but they are looking. They are looking at being able to do. I think at the moment we've got as far as doing some residential trips, some of the selective trips. trips that their children are on, but I think that they are looking at that to see what they can do. And the idea is that the online system, that everything, you'll be able to pay everything through there. I just want to finish with a bit of a note about our PTA. I think it's one of the strengths of the school is our parent body. Through the PTA, really enhance much of everything that kind of goes on and happens in the school, and particularly the learning experiences of the children. The PTA is an elected committee, but there are lots of meetings open to everyone. They give a lot of support to the school. And a lot of fundraising and also supporting with feedback and new initiatives across the school. We've got Sharianne and we've got Alex here today from our PTA. I know that they're very keen and the PTA to kind of help and support any new parents who are coming. An important part of the PTA is also our class reps. For each class in the primary campus, we'll have one or maybe two class reps who support the work that the PTA does. Their job is also just to keep in touch with the parents and getting to welcome new parents. They often organise little coffee mornings so everybody can get together. Most classes do have a WhatsApp group where they send little reminders out as well. But also class reps can help mobilise everybody when we have big events, special events around the school. I don't know, Alex, if you want to say anything else about the PTA?
Not really, except that most of us have badges, so if you have any questions or just want some advice on something, you do feel free to stop in the PTA and just ask some questions. The next big event that we're going to be working on this term is the Spring Fair, which is 4th March, I think, Saturday morning at the ECAs campus. So keep an eye on class times for information about the event that we organise, and let us know if you'd like to get involved in any way as well.
There are open meetings at the primary campus, JBPTA, and again at the secondary campus as well. We'll have asked in admissions if you're happy to share your details with the class reps, and they will be able to put you. That's obviously optional if you want, and they'll put you on their group. It's mostly social events, bits of information that the class reps will send out. Any important or official information will always come from the teacher or the school. Well, I think that's it today. Again, I just all of us a warm welcome to the school. Please don't hesitate to come in and ask and stop the PTA or any existing parents or to come into the office or stop any one of us with any questions that you may have.
One question on the communications.
Yes. Yes.
Is there a limit as to the number of email addresses and mobile numbers for you to send to?
We usually send to two contacts. Generally,
it's because it's only my mobile phone.
Yeah.
Yes. So if there's an addition or changes, who do I reach out to?
Go to the school office and give the changes. Yes. So in most cases, for most families, we're sending one or two,
yes.
Priority one and priority two. If parents are away or there's a specific reason why you want the email sent, they can be changed to somebody else's. As well. So if you want to add any more, you need to go into the school office, and they'll do that for us on our system.
Okay. Yes. So when you say priority one,
yes,
you really will send to one first, and you will come reach one.
Most will go out to both. Yeah, both. Okay. So that's when you registered with the school.
So we just
parents or guardians, depending on what
it is.
Yeah.
Okay.
Come and tell us if you're not getting it. Particularly with the SMS system, sometimes if parents are away or going to be out of contact and there's a grandparent or somebody is guardian for the children, you can come in and we can change for a short period of time the telephone number if you need to change.
Do you use the system to pay the school fees?
Not at the moment, no.
I think that's in the pipeline, and they're looking to be able to do that. We have a you know, we've got a one-stop center, a parents center over the building, and then there's Colourful Building where our dining hall is, and upstairs where the admissions are. There's also the accounts offices up there next to the uniform shop and our parent deli as well. I just finally, we do hold workshops every Thursday in the primary campus, and there's also a selection of workshops at different times at the secondary campus. We will always notify you what's coming up next, as well as you can go into the class gateway and see. So we do regularly hope to see you. Some people yesterday took one of our guides to learning, a little bit more about the curriculum in the school. If you didn't take one, I'm going to leave some at the front that you may find useful to take away with you. Other than that, thank you very much. I will stay around for a few minutes if you've got any questions or you weren't able to log on.
One other thing, and when I came to the library, parents can take books at the library as well as their children. So if you go in and get a library account, so just go into the library here and you can take out at least 20 books at a time. So I didn't know that until last time.
You join the library as well.
Just off the back of that, one thing that is also worth mentioning is the school also subscribes to something called Press Reader. Has anybody come across that before? If you download the app, the Press Reader app, whenever you're connected to the school network, you can basically download any publication from magazines, newspapers from all over the world for free to read on your device. So if you do want more information about that, have a chat with either myself or the librarians.
My wife loves it. She misses her magazines from the UK. Mm-hmm.
Sit up at the parent deli.
So we can just download the app on our own.
Just go to the App Store, search for Press Reader, and then as long as you're in school, you load it up, you can download a bunch of magazines, and then you can take your device away one day with you and read it all day.
I just do that.
It's very good. Thank you very much.
I mentioned
that. There's a few at the front of the other learning guides. We didn't take one yesterday. We've got some here. Additional ones.